is 9 a.m. on May 9th, and we are packing up our bags and heading to Toronto, Canada. I just got done packing up my stuff after, and like, last minutes. So, now I've got to go pick up Noaa. And by the way, yes, I am filming in my car, but obviously, I am not moving, because that would be really stupid. So, this is the first ever road trip video we're doing, so hopefully it's good, and hopefully it doesn't suck, but either way, the trip's going to be fun, so catch you guys later.
Well, we're packed up, we got the cooler finally ready and set, we got gas, we got all our goods.
So we got GPS, because apparently the GPS that Noaa possesses, you have to download the Canadian maps like it's some kind of unlockable.
Yeah, but I think you got to pay for them.
Yeah, so you literally have to pay to see a map of Canada.
To pay for Canada.
That's whatever. A good 2 hours later, we're finally on the road.
Yeah.
You know? So, and actually, we're further away than when we started because we had to drive to a different part of the city to go to his bank and go to Myers and all this other
Best
stuff.
Best Buy
to try to get the maps to work. But, you know, the guy informed us, like, yeah, you need to download the Canadian maps. And it's like, so literally, Our GPS would have been like, we crossed into Canada, it would have been just like, oh, I don't know where the fuck you guys are now. You know, you're lost.
Sorry about the camera work, still getting used to this.
Yeah,
it's a bumpy ride.
We're new to this, you know. Just gonna do a little. we are now driving to
Toronto, Canada.
Yeah.
This is my first time in Canada, so.
I've been there twice, actually. I went there once to go to Niagara Falls, and I went to London, Canada for a White Stripes concert.
Oh, how'd that work?
Both times are fine. Yeah. This is before you had to get like a fucking extra or enhanced license or a passport in order to get to Canada.
Yeah, which I did.
I did too.
I was going to see New Japan, so it was all worth it.
Oh yeah, absolutely. Yeah. But I was smart enough to buy the enhanced license when I got my license, not like 4 years ago.
Well, aren't you smart?
Yeah, you know, thinking ahead. Yeah. So.
But if this hotel has waffles, then I'd call this trip a complete success.
Yes. Please tell the story of you in the waffle bar, I guess.
I mean, I don't know how much of a story there is. I love waffles, and I feel like I went to a hotel once, and I paid $100 for a night, and they had waffles. I feel like anytime you spend $100 on a hotel, you should be able to get waffles. I think that's a fair.
Yeah. Not just waffles, a waffle bar.
Well, a waffle bar, yeah.
Right.
Specifically a waffle bar.
But that is the only, like, whenever we're getting a hotel, and this is actually the first time we've ever gotten a hotel for a wrestling show. We were going to do one for Chicago not too long ago, but that fell through. Noah's one request is just like, it's like, hey, I found a hotel. They have a waffle bar? I don't think so. Got to find another one.
Didn't we actually call the hotel?
Yeah, tell that story.
Well, I had to find out, so I called, and, you know, they were asking me these questions. Oh, how long are you going to stay? How long? You know, I wasn't interested in that. I just needed to know, can I get some waffles? You guys got a waffle? All right, thank you. That's all I need to know.
For my part, it was just like, hi, yes, I'm just wondering, do you have a waffle bar? And it's like, okay, thank you. And she's like, that's it. And then me, because I'm like, book that hotel.
Yeah, they did have one, yes. As a matter of fact.
This one does have a breakfast. I'm sure they have waffles. They have a pool, too. So.
Oh, man. I'm getting wet and wild.
Get your swim in your bebs on.
Your what?
Swim in your bebs.
Swim in your bebs?
Swim and your bebs. Not in your bebs.
Oh, okay.
You're not going to swim in your bebs. You know? Like,
I don't know what
bev
is, man.
Beverage.
Bev. Oh. I thought you said beb with a B. Like, beb?
You're a fucking moron. This is going to be a long trip.
Yeah, it is.
Yeah.
Just shut the
five,
hell up.
Five hour plus drive. So.
So, you'll get the highlights.
We probably won't get there till 4 o'clock.
Check-in time's 3 o'clock, so.
Yeah, we have to be, man, I don't.
What is a good Canadian cuisine?
I know they like poutine, which is like French fries with gravy.
I think we'll stick with pizza.
I think we'll stick with pizza. we're meeting a couple guys. We're meeting the gentleman behind, one of the gentlemen. I don't know like how many people are behind the weekly wrestling podcast,
yep.
And Bushido blog. We're meeting both those guys.
I'm pretty excited to.
Yeah,
these guys, that should be cool.
The only thing is, like, I literally have no idea what these guys look like because they run sites. They don't have like there's no pictures of them. I don't think. So we'll see what they're like. You know, they're, if they're.
So this is kind of like a blind date.
Yeah. So if this footage is found and we're missing, you know who to blame.
Yep.
So you know.
But you won't know what they look like. So.
Well, you know, you can check their. You know, you can follow them on Twitter. Like, hey, where'd these guys go?
Yeah.
I don't know. But yeah, this is gonna be a fun trip.
There's the bridge.
Coming up on
Canada.
Let me see if I can. Oh, that's backwards now. Let's see if we can. There's the zoom for you, folks. There's the Canadian flag on the bridge to Canada sign.
That is a bridge, and it looks like the fucking bridge is packed.
Oh, this should be fun.
Well, it looks like it's maybe that's coming in, so we should be fine. Because we're not coming until Sunday, so.
Okay. All right. Well.
And we're on the bridge.
We are taking the ride. There's Alex, your driver.
Oh my god, we're on the bridge to Canada.
We're on the only bridge to Canada.
Yeah, we're going on the one road to Canada. Okay. So,
well, we don't need trucks.
We are not a truck, we are a car.
A little bit of Detroit in the background for you.
Yeah, you know.
Nice. The beautiful Detroit. Okay, here's the good shots coming up, I'm hoping, hopefully.
Asshole, that's cars only, you motherfucker.
You're gonna have to sift through some of this terrible shit.
Okay, this guy's a fucking moron.
He doesn't know what he's doing.
We're just gonna get behind in front of this dude's car.
Let's just move right along here.
Right on there.
There you go. Take a nice sharp curve.
Well, so we went to the toll operator and asked about if we can exchange American currency. Turns out it was the building right behind us, so we pulled in there and got all this.
Fat stacks is what we did.
Fat stacks of Canadian money, which is very colorful, by the way.
Yes, and it has the Queen of Canada on them. So that's
the
cool.
Queen of England. Canada.
No shit.
Yeah. Oh, I thought you were being serious. I'm like you're a fucking moron. So, okay.
We are about to cross into Canada now.
Yes. This is a crossing into Canada take two. We'll start filming again when we are not, you know, talking to the toll operators. We're not going to be an assholes.
All right.
And we're back. This is
the bridge view. We got a little bit of Detroit air on our left.
Woo-hoo. A lot of traffic coming back.
Yeah, not that. There's the beautiful bridge.
Ambassador Bridge.
Yes. And look at this skyline over here. Oh, that's a truck. Damn it, we got the truck.
There's a peak. There's a peak.
We might not get it. Here, I'll go to my right. There's a little bit more. That's
a little bit more depressing.
That's the part of Detroit that most people know. And then the other side is the rich people. Let's see.
Rich businesses.
Business folk, if you will.
Yeah, we don't have a good view of coming into Canada.
I got nothing over here, man. Nope, oh, yeah. I got... There we go. A little bit of you,
hell
a little bit of...
Yeah,
that's beautiful.
That's a picture right there.
Oh, and we got Canada to the right.
A tale of two cities right there. That is a good picture right there.
That is gorgeous.
I wish I could enjoy it more, but I am driving.
And there it is, Ambassador Bridge, spelled backwards.
We are now officially crossing the wall into the north. Or beyond the... We're going beyond the wall.
Uncharted territory.
Yes. Like the land of forever winter, it's called by many. Oh my god.
Hold on to you, Sax.
Okay, we're good. There's some cars parked on the side of the bridge. Oh man, the truck is coming over. And look how lively
it's
and green.
Luscious. Yeah. I'm filming the sky. I'm embarrassing myself here.
Yeah, look how luscious and green it is compared to Detroit, which is like a haze of fog and
I know, it's like we just escaped. That's okay.
That's okay.
University of Windsor.
We're gonna be coming back to America, you know, eventually.
Yes.
Well, I don't know. We do get free health care over here, so maybe we'll stick around.
You know, might break a leg or something. I don't know.
I don't know. We'll find out. But
once things get a little more interesting.
Yeah. Well, driving is the most boring part of the trip. Like we literally began like the trip, and like 10 minutes later, we're just like, I'm bored. Just like, you know,
there's not much to do.
Driving sucks. Oh, and for the mile count, we are currently at 74.2 miles.
Not bad.
That does not include the trips to the store and everything like that. It was like, that's like official, like, okay, trips, we're officially going now to Canada, you know, so, yeah.
All right, well.
Get a lovely picture of this guy's bumper.
Yep, there you go.
And some
Dale Earnhardt.
Look at this. There's a guy Or one, that's a woman, I think. Yeah, just standing there doing.
Hey, lady, how you doing?
Just, I would like that to be your job. Just like, yeah, you're just gonna stand there.
You're gonna watch traffic.
Okay. That's you. I don't know where the fuck we're supposed to go, but we're gonna figure this out. Okay, we're going outward.
Alright, well, this is where we sign off for now.
This guy doesn't know where he's going. Oh, no. Look at this guy.
That's dangerous, my friend.
That is dangerous. Look at this guy's hole.
You got you on film. Poorly. But you're there.
A camera.
Alright, time to bilingual service. So.
So, we are now officially in Canada after getting interrogated by the fucking customs official, whatever.
That's not really a fun process.
No. Dude, like, we're perfectly innocent. We're not terrorists. And, like, it's fucking scary, man.
But, so I went and.
Okay,
go ahead.
When I got my license, when I turned 21, I ordered an enhanced license. Apparently.
Wait. Okay. You're killing my story here. All right. So, like, a month. Maybe a little more than a month ago, I went and got my enhanced license so I could come over to Canada and see this show. You know, paid my $40, waited. I was worried I wasn't even going to get it in the mail in time. Well, it showed up, and so I'm pretty stoked. We just get back, we get to the border there, we show our license, and she asks, you got a passport? And we're thinking, no, don't we? All we need is an enhanced license, and that's what Alex basically says to her, and she says, well, Alexander doesn't have one. And we're like, what?
I ordered one.
And she says, does that look like a enhanced license to you?
I don't know what the fucking enhanced license look like.
It does say enhanced license on it.
I didn't know that until I saw yours. I'm like, oh shit. I'm like, well, maybe they changed it since I got mine, you know?
Right. But she asks us a few more questions, and here we are.
Yeah.
We're in Canada. Whew. So.
That lady was good at her job. I'll tell you that. Like, and I'm like, it's like, you got any firearm or anything? Like, nope. And like, she's like, what about you, Noaa? It's like, nope, no, ma'am. Just
do you own any? Noaa, don't.
Where do you guys work? It's like, she's like, oh my God.
Fucking. Where do I work? Oh no. She's gonna know that I'm American.
Jesus Christ, man. Fucking scary. So, yeah.
That was our experience at the border.
And if you don't mind, I gotta go take a piss. And apparently, I'm fucking scared.
Apparently, you do not need a passport to get into Canada.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah. Well, you know, maybe she lets off easily, but like, I'm gonna get back in the country. Like, they can't keep you out of the country, sir. It's like, okay, good enough for me.
That's right.
As long as they can get back in my country, I don't give a shit. I'm here, you know, ain't kicking me out, Canadians. I'm here to stay. All right, guys. So we're gonna go relax.
We're gonna stop and use the bathroom. So.
We gotta breathe. Well, we're here in the beautiful Canadian countryside.
Of nothingness.
And over to show it. And over here on this side, we have nothing as well.
Yeah, it sucks. It's pretty basic over here, but hey.
Basic Canadian starting point. What do you think, Daniel Bryan? Think Canada sucks?
Yes.
this is how we've been keeping ourselves entertained for the past, 2 hours.
Yeah, we got another 2.5, 3 hours.
Yeah. No, we got at least 3 hours.
Yeah. So.
And by the way, for the next 2 hours, we're stuck on the same fucking highway.
Actually, I'm kind of okay with that.
Me too, but it's like at the same time, it's like, you know, how boring is, you know, is that thing? Boring is good. But is that sheep wool?
No. Well. I don't know.
That's sheep wool.
Could be. Jesus. Went by a bunch of sheep wool. Sorry, you didn't get to see that.
Yeah, nice camera job.
Well, you know, I'm not used to using an iPod that only faces you.
Well, then you should be using yours.
That's our map, so.
Yeah, well, that's just your opinion, dude. Okay, yeah, so, all right,
well, just checking in.
We'd like to be in a more entertaining, but, you know, we're literally stuck in a car.
In the least entertaining part of Canada.
We have this ship back home. Like, this is nothing.
Yeah.
This literally looks like the area around the city where we live. That's a third Tim Hortons we've passed. A
lot of Tim Hortons. Canadians love Tim.
They do. It's a good name.
It's a good name. But if you close your eyes, does it almost feel like nothing changed at all? And if you close your eyes, does it almost feel like you've been here before? Now I'm beginning to be an optimist about this. I'm beginning to be an optimist about this. Oh, where do we begin? The road of our sins. Oh, where do we begin? The road of our sins. And the walls kept tumbling down in the city that we love. Great clouds all over the hills, bringing darkness from above. If you close your eyes, does it almost feel like nothing changed at all? And if you close your eyes, does it almost feel like you've been here before? I'm gonna be an optimist about this. I'm gonna be an optimist about this. If you close your eyes, does it almost feel like nothing changed at all?
Hey, and this is the room where we'll be staying for the next 2 days and probably wanting to kill each other by the end of it. Mm-hmm. Nice TV. Probably not going to do anything with that.
Look at this view over here.
Oh yeah, look at this view.
Glorious power lines, and there's a water tower. I believe Canada is known for its water towers.
I believe so.
There's a Congress Center across the street.
There's some shops. Look, they got a Subway.
Wait a second, is that a Tim Hortons?
Is that a Tim Hortons? That is a Tim Hortons. We have a Tim Hortons.
That might be the 217th Tim Hortons.
And look at all these assholes below us. Hi, maggots.
Hey.
Okay, and then we have this lovely desk here. We have a cooler with stuff. We got ICE, Cards Against Humanity. Maybe we'll be playing that this weekend. Spoiler alert.
Uh-oh.
DVDs to be signed. The two beds, obviously two of them because, you know.
We don't sleep together on vacation.
Yeah, you know. Okay. And, yeah, so,
this is the location where we'll be staying in. Probably, we'll probably do some filming here. Maybe, you know, we'll see.
All right. Anything to say, Ed?
Hey, enjoy. Because that's what we're doing.
Okay.
We're gonna go get some food and some snacks so that we don't waste our money on other shit. We're exciting. That's what we do.
Yeah. Let's go to a Tim Hortons, but like, I wonder if there's another one right over there. If you can see
that would be convenient.
There is a Tim Hortons literally, like, less than a mile apart.
Not even a block.
Not even a block. Canada's.
They love Tim Hortons.
Yeah, apparently Tim Hortons are the Starbucks of Canada.
Noaa is embracing his inner Christopher Daniels by having an apple teeny.
A real man's drink.
Thoughts?
Looking for alcohol, or Noaa was, and we just walked by this window and we were like, maybe this place has it. I wonder, you know, if this place sells alcohol at all. Rough shot in the dark.
Worth a shot.
But apparently it does. So, success. Yay.
Yay. Beer.
Yeah, he can get drunk and I can stay sober.
Yeah, you're already one behind.
I only had one apple teeny, you know, had the...
Yeah, you can't speak, so what does that tell us?
Had to pay tribute to bad influence. So, fair. Off we go, back to the hotel.
So, Noaa thought we needed some entrance music, so here you go.
So, me and Noaa didn't really care for the artwork that the room had, did we, Noaa?
No, it just wasn't fit my taste.
It needed a little bit more style. We think it's an improvement. Hey, you guys want to get a view of the room? Okay. Hi, Noaa! Okay. Boy, that's a really romantic-looking sunset. And I'm stuck in a hotel with this guy. Can't win them all.
It is Saturday, May 10th. It's time for the ROH show today. And the first thing we see in the morning? a lone hubcap down on the streets of Toronto. Maybe I'll go pick it up and keep it as a souvenir. Probably not. Just a nice thought.
Well, we are looking for breakfast right now, and it turns out I messed up, and this place doesn't offer free breakfast. Very disappointing, so we're going to go try to find a place that serves breakfast.
No waffles, man.
No waffles. And no Denny's around here. None of Denny's in Canada.
Tim Hortons.
We are driving into Toronto now, it's a pretty nice skyline we got here. We're going to try to get up.
Try to get a little bit of a picture.
We didn't bring our video camera, so we're using a flip cam, and we,
don't hate on us too much, but yeah, it's beautiful. We can't see the tower. We might be able to see
tower.
Gonna
come up right in here. But, we'll get some pictures of it, sure. We're probably going to walk up to it,
There it is.
Yeah, like there in the background. It's not that big,
Yeah, it seemed bigger.
It's 4 out of 10.
We'll see you guys at the Hall of Fame.
Yep.
Noaa just tried to put some coins in a fountain or whatever, and
mine got bounced off the rail and fell back out. So,
it's a pretty sizable fountain.
That might be bad luck. So we might be in trouble.
Yeah, mine went in, so I'm okay, I think.
Okay, I'm fucked then. Anyway, Hockey Hall of Fame was really, really cool.
Success.
Got some cool pictures. And, yeah.
Got to touch the cup.
Got to touch the cup, yeah. Felt it, caressed it. So, now we're going to find a bathroom and probably head back.
So, we're at the Hockey Hall of Fame, and it's really nice for the spinning door. So, we got to commit to it. Hey, just got to dive right in. Let's see how this goes.
Okay.
Oh, no. I better wait for the next one. I'm in.
Am I supposed to spin too?
I don't know.
So we found the CN Tower, but there's also something else popping up. I don't know if you can see it, but there is a guy on that building hanging from the fucking wire, cleaning windows. Never in a million years would you give me to do that job. What about you?
No, I think I'll pass on that.
I don't know if I even see it, but yeah. So we're gonna go see how much it costs to get up the CN Tower. We're probably not gonna go up there though, but yeah. We'll see. CN Tower. Pretty big.
All right. We are on our way back to the hotel after having a heck of a time trying to figure out our way out of Toronto. Back onto the highway anyway. We didn't think ahead and get the directions. I think we mentioned that earlier. And so we had to navigate with my phone and it was having a lot of problems. But we made it.
Yep.
This all could have been avoided if we had the GPS maps.
You didn't have to buy Canada. Yeah. So I just want to send out a big fuck you to Garmin. If you're thinking about getting a GPS, go with a TomTom.
Probably. So we're going to head back to the hotel. We do some relaxation, swimming around maybe. Mm. And then I got to get ready for the show.
And it's only 11:30. We've been...
Yeah. Like we got up like at 8 o'clock and we were... Like, we were kind of, like, done walking around in the Hockey Hall of Fame and stuff at, like, 10 o'clock, and we just, like, wandered around the city for a little bit.
Yeah, we've gotten a lot in a short period of time, so.
Yeah. And, imagine, the crazy thing is, like, we probably would, you know, I was thinking about sleeping in. It's like, well, fuck that, you know, now we're, but yeah, we went and saw the sights. We're going to try to find a way to get to the Lake Ontario before we go to the show, because, you know, I've been in every lake, Great Lake, except for Lake Ontario, so
be cool to
gotta finally stamp my last Great Lake on my Great Lakes card.
Alright.
So to speak.
So that's the plan as of now. So we will see you guys.
Yeah.
When we back from the pool. Noaa took a little tumble down the water slide, as did I. But we got a little bit of footage of that, so enjoy that. Anything to add?
No.
Okay.
Well, we just left the hotel, we went and got Subway, got a little snack to keep us,
tide us over a bit,
until after the show, and, we're gonna go get some supplies,
get some streamers,
yep, gotta get some gas, and then we are, gotta go pick up one more other thing, and then we're gonna be at the show, so,
we're on our way, and this is, like you said, this is what we came for.
Yeah, so. This is, absolutely, man, this is, you know, I'm already getting the jitters, you know.
I'm like, oh yeah.
Look,
I'm so excited.
I'm already
right
drinking
now.
Out, man.
You gotta contain yourself, man. You gotta make it to the main event.
I need to pace myself.
Yes.
Alright, but yeah. So we're gonna be dropping there, so stay tuned.
Right, well Alex and I stopped and got some gas and Alex wanted to go on a little bit of a rant, so here we go.
Oh, we'll turn and show the button.
Oh yeah, here's this bus. I don't know if you can see it.
That big ass bus. We were pumping gas at that station or the one next to it, and it's not that much room. This fucking bus pulls up and it's like leaves like that much fucking space between that my car and that fucking bus. So much so that Noaa couldn't get in. I had to pull forward. And it's just like, you know, I understand that there's no spots available maybe that you can either besides that one, but just couldn't you just fucking wait 2 seconds?
Really?
So. Fuck you, that bus driver.
And we figured out how to use how the gas exchange works in Canada. So
it took a little bit of time, like because like we were looking around, like it looks like it was like $100.
Yeah, it says 133.9. We're like
because there's four numbers on it, and you figure, well, with four numbers, you know, there's only 2 cents. Well, apparently they got it there, but it's like it was like 133 something for a liter. So we figured it out, and turned out we it's about the same for U.S. as it is for Canada. Maybe a little more expensive in Canada, but we're not sure.
And now we're hopping on the highway. It looks like we're gonna run into some traffic, but
that's why we're leaving 3 hours before the event starts, and hour and a half before the doors open for the autograph session. So
yeah, we're not gonna miss a thing.
We're well prepared, and we don't mind waiting in line. That's part of the deal. So let's see how this trip goes.
Trying to get a look at this skyline here in the distance. Boom, look at that. That's beautiful, huh?
Seeing my expert driving as well.
And grand reveal!
There it is.
There is Toronto, Canada.
Yes. The site of Global Wars.
That is our GPS.
Yeah.
So, yeah, I'm really glad we got this shot.
It's
great. Just a great view coming in from this way. We had to take a slightly different way, but it all worked out.
It's a beautiful city, man. I'm really glad I got to walk around then. It's a great city. Highly recommend people come visit. They're very, very friendly here. And we might come back another time, but probably won't be a casual trip. It'd be like a very big event, but seeing Mania here would be a really, really cool event. But we're super hyped for this show.
Yeah, cannot wait.
Made a little pit stop because right out here, that's Lake Ontario, and that's the last Great Lake I have to step. So we're gonna do this. We're gonna go, dip our toes.
Watch the trash. Yep.
And that is really goddamn cold.
Oh yeah.
I don't know if you can see that, but we just dipped our toes, and I got my pants wet, of course. God.
Now we're gonna have sandy feet.
Yeah, we're gonna have sandy feet. So, but it was worth it because we just been in Lake Ontario. So yeah.
Success.
Well, we finally made it, folks. That right there is the Ted Reeve Arena.
Got some donuts. They didn't have donuts.
We got cupcakes for Elgin's wife because apparently he asked for them on Twitter. So we decided to be nice and try to suck up to Michael Elgin as best we can.
I ran about a kilometer.
Yeah, that was a whole adventure. We'll probably tell that story later. But we'll see you guys inside the venue. This place is awesome. Chaos. And I love it. Also, shout out to vending machines.
Oh yeah, and here's your change, brother.
Thank you.
We just taught somebody how to use the damn pool.
Apparently in Canada they don't teach you how to use a vending machine. Guy's pretty heavy set. You should be knowing how to use a vending machine.
Just got done with the autograph signing. Got a shitload of autographs and pictures. Yeah. Some of them didn't turn out right because they fucking turn off the house lights to test the lighting for the camera. So
you got a couple, red eyes, but hey,
we got pretty good pictures of all the New Japan guys, so we're good. And we got like autographs from all of them, so that's pretty fucking awesome.
Oh, yeah, we're stoked. So, people are starting to file in.
Yeah, Assault and Battery and Miguel are sitting at, like right in front of us, so that's gonna be cool to talk to them, I guess, for a little bit. So this is gonna be an awesome night.
I can't wait.
Woo!
Awesome! That was awesome! That was awesome! That was awesome! Introducing first, Rainmaker, Kazuchika
Okada! 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 Okada!
Okada!
Yes, thank you.
So just got over. Pretty damn good show, I think. We enjoyed it quite a bit.
Yep.
So, we're going to do some pictures and we're going to take off probably. So we just left the venue. The guys from Bushido Blog and Wrestling Weekly podcast. We met Bushido Blog. The guy runs that. Super cool dude.
Yeah, Baxter. He's a
great
guy.
Great dude. Can't really hang out tonight because, you know, Mother's Day tomorrow and all that stuff. So we're just going to go back to our hotel and chill.
Plus, shiny as hell.
Yeah, you're a glossy motherfucker. And plus, we're super tired, and I want to take a shower because I'm sweaty. Because, you know, wrestling fans are pigs, and you sweat.
Smell.
Yeah,
smell.
Yeah. So I guess we'll just head back to the hotel. Maybe we'll find some people to hang out with or something. I don't know. We might hang out with some people. That is the skyline of Toronto. That's a really wonderful sight to see after a great show.
Yeah, especially at night. It's really beautiful.
That's our GPS talking.
She never shuts up.
Yeah, she's a bitch. Yeah, that is a gorgeous sight. Toronto is a fantastic city to come visit to.
It really is. It's a beautiful city. People are as friendly as hell. You can approach damn near anybody.
Yep.
So
very friendly people. A lot of, like, they even got nice like little small communities outside of Toronto. So very, very nice place. Highly, highly recommend.
Definitely.
You guys come out here and visit it.
Full of fair-skinned beauties.
But, you know, absolutely. The return trip is definitely a possibility, and it's one I would definitely consider making, but,
that's gonna be down the road, my friends.
Yeah, it's not gonna be, the Ring of Honor is coming back in September. We will not be here in September, that's for damn sure. But, a return trip to Toronto is certainly something I'd be all for, because this is a wonderful place to visit, and, if I had more money, I would love to stay longer. Anything to add, Noah?
I think you said it best, my friend.
All right, man. Well, we'll get back to you guys when we get to the hotel. Just got back to the hotel. We're parked the car and everything. Head inside and we got some grub. More Subway.
Yep, second time of day.
That's all right. Because it's cheap and there's not really many other fast food places around here. And we don't want to sit down in a restaurant because we're fucking tired. So we are exhausted. We're probably going to go in and chill, shower, and get to bed, and then gotta get on the road tomorrow morning. So, woohoo! Anything to add?
No, you crushed it, man.
Alright.
Alright, man. It's time for bed.
Yeah, you're right.
Should we hug?
Yeah, we should. Just packing up the room. As you can see, it's a little bit in worse shape than
disarray
than we originally came in and got it, but good trip. Anything that, you know?
It was a great trip, and we made our money.
Yes, we did. So, successful, I think.
I'd say so.
All right. Looking out to the parking lot to load the car up, and we see this. Nice parking, asshole.
Yep, that's asshole. Reserve parking.
Yep. Wouldn't be staying in a hotel without having to go down to the lobby and get a spare key because we locked ourselves out of our room.
About an hour before we're supposed to be out of the room anyway.
Of course. I was hoping we could avoid that, but we're idiots.
So, comes with the territory, I suppose.
Yeah, stupid Americans, you know.
Well, we're about to leave. A little leftover liquor. I don't think we're going to be able to take it across the border. It's open, so I'm going to have to dump it. And it pains me to do this, but... no.
All right, we are heading out of Toronto now. I think we've actually gotten out of it. Back on the highway, heading home.
This is technically take two of this video because we tried recording it on my iPod and it told us to stop recording because we have it's full personally.
So yeah, this is going to be the
close-up edition.
And the hand on edition with the camera, so probably gonna be a little shitty, but whatever. It's all right.
But we just checked out of the International Plaza Hotel. Nice place, really nice.
Very nice.
And we thought we'd give you guys some thoughts and rundown of the trip and the show. So yeah, want to dive in, man?
All right. We left our hotel pretty early because we wanted to go to this bakery because Elgin had asked for gluten-free donuts for his wife. And we Googled it and found that, oh, there's a couple of places closed, including one that's 7 minutes away from the venue. So it was like, let's leave early. We'll go there and get donuts for Elgin's wife, and we'll suck them to Elgin, you know. And so we did. We get to this like little old town part of Toronto, very small, very much like a residential area of Toronto. Very, very nice.
Yeah, very nice.
And it's like, it was like two lanes, so we parked, but we weren't sure if it was a parking spot, it was parallel parking. So Noaa decided he's just gonna run down to the bakery, just a kilometer away, and get the stuff, and then I'm gonna pick him up.
Yeah, and so I was running, it felt like endlessly. I kept checking my GPS, and I had only gone like a couple hundred meters, you know. I ran down there, dodging, weaving people and children and dogs and all the sorts, and let a blind woman know she can cross the street. And then I made it to the bakery, and they didn't have any donuts. So I was kind of panic-stricken at that point. But luckily, they had a couple of cupcakes and a raspberry chocolate tart, gluten-free. So we got that and took it to the show.
Yep.
And we gave it to Elgin.
He was very, very thankful.
Yes, he was very humble, and he, like you said, very thankful for it. So that was cool.
We actually had to meet all the New Japan and ROH guys because we paid the $160 to meet them all. Met Elgin first. Super, super nice guy, as always. Really a humble dude, I think. Kevin Steen, awesome guy. I mean, he's great. He apparently remembered my name. Like, all the time I tweeted about him, whatever, which is, like, that's incredible that he would remember my name. That's super an honor to be remembered by Kevin Steen.
Yeah, you really wouldn't expect these guys to remember you because they're all over the place.
Right.
Constantly traveling, meeting hundreds and thousands of different people. So
right.
That was really cool.
Yep. Briscoes, awesome dudes. Mm-hmm. I mean, they're super nice. The Young Bucks, I mean, super fun, nice dudes.
Yeah, those guys are, they would be a blast to just hang out with and...
Oh, absolutely.
And chill with.
Jay Lethal, really, really nice to meet that guy for the first time. Super nice, very, very approachable and very easy to talk to. First time actually meeting him ever.
Yeah. Me. Yeah, I talked to him in Chicago a little bit, but just in passing. But it was nice to get to talk to him a little bit more, and he's a great guy, like Alex was saying.
Yeah.
After that?
Carl Anderson.
Anderson, he seems like a funny dude.
Yeah, really, really cool dude. AJ Styles, honored to meet that guy. He's one of the best TNA wrestlers of all time. IWGP champion right now, which seeing that belt in person is just, wow, it's a beautiful belt, and it's heavy as shit.
Yeah, and like you said, beautiful, and I felt like that belt really, when you see it on AJ, it makes ROH feel bigger.
I think so.
So that was really cool.
Yeah.
And next to him was Adam Cole.
Yeah, Adam Cole. Yeah. Oh man.
He's such a humble, nice guy.
Oh, he's great.
But he photobombed.
He likes to like do like a little photobomb almost like when he takes a picture. And that was super funny.
And we got to shake his hand, and he has a very sensual touch. It was very, it was all that I wanted it to be.
Super nice to meet Adam Cole. He's a nice guy. Then we met the New Japan guys, Forever Hooligans first. Awesome dudes, man. Alex Kozlov's a great guy. Rocky's funny as hell. You know, they're all great. Alex Kozlov really liked my name, which I thought was funny as hell.
Yeah, he said, he asked what his name was, and put two Alex, and then he said, oh, should I just stop here?
and like they, the way the autograph session worked was, you can get a picture or a signed 8x10. And we get up to them, it's like, you guys want an autograph? It's like, oh, well, you can only get a picture, or it's like, but do you want one? It's like, yeah, we'll take it. Like, there you go,
and
man.
And Kozlov says, okay, you guys will be the last ones.
Yeah, because like, apparently they didn't know what the fuck was going on. They were like, they're just giving away autographs. Like, they didn't give a shit.
That was cool.
So yeah, they were nice guys. Jado and Gato were next. Really got an honor to meet those guys.
Yeah,
like,
it really was.
Two of the greatest bookers in wrestling today, probably. Super nice, you know, really, really nice. Seemed kind of like they've been around for so long, so
this was, yeah, they've been there, done that.
Yeah, so I don't want to make it sound like they're bitter or something, but like it's just like they've been around the world, they've seen all this, so it's kind of like, you know, they're used to this sort of thing.
Yeah.
So I think Nakamura was next. Awesome dude. I mean,
yeah.
Oh my god.
I was starstruck by it. I didn't even know what to say. I don't know if you could have understood what I was saying anyway, but
I think all the Japanese guys spoke English pretty well.
Yeah,
like they all
seem
to understand us.
I think that they can understand it better than they can speak it.
Yeah. Got to like kind of pose with the IC title.
That
awesome.
Belt is beautiful. But the strap on that thing, it's
like
getting beat up. It's almost like it's never been changed.
Maybe. Then the legend himself, the living legend, Kazuchika Okada. Super, super humble dude. For a guy as talented as he is, so humble about it.
Yeah, and it's really surprising how humble he is. But he was a fantastic guy. You know, he took all our compliments with a smile and everything, and he again, these guys just blew me away, honestly. I thought it'd be like a shake your hand kind of thing. No, these guys are really cool.
And speaking of humble, we got to meet the icon, Jushin Thunder Liger. The guy who probably single-handedly made the wrestling style what it is today.
Yeah, I got chills just when you mentioned it.
Yeah.
We get up to him, and he signs an autograph, takes a picture, shakes your hand, and
he doesn't just shake your hand. He, like, grabs by both hands, like, thank you so much. You know, he is the most humble man I've ever met. For a guy of his, like, just longevity, for as long as he's been in wrestling, for him to be still that humble.
It's amazing.
It really gives you faith in some of the wrestlers, you know, that, like, they see this guy, and, like, that's how you're supposed to act.
And the way he acted was almost like he was honored to meet us.
Yeah.
You know, which was the opposite. We were so honored to meet this guy.
Oh, absolutely. Just incredible, man. That's a memory that's gonna last a lifetime.
Definitely.
Meeting Hiroshi Tanahashi again. Very humble dude. Very nice.
Yep.
I
think he's been there and done that a little.
Yeah, but you know, he was cool because like he was AI even after the show, just sitting there taking autographs and signing pictures.
Yeah, he was the only guy that came back out, so that was really neat.
Yeah, so I think he's very much like kind of like John Cena almost, like where he's like he's an ambassador for the company, and he's willing to go out there and meet fans, you know. Who was next? Time Splitters. Kushida. Okay, well, Alex Shelley meet him, of course. He was kind of cool. And then, like, we mentioned we're from Michigan, and he just perked right up on that.
That was really cool. We actually talked to him. He asked us, you know, what part. And we told him we were from around Lansing, and he says, oh, you're Westerners.
Yeah.
So I guess I never thought of it like that. But, he was cool. Told us to have a safe trip home.
Yeah, really nice. I thought it was very interesting because Kushida very much struck me as, I don't want to say like a young, very much a young wrestler who's learning from Alex Shelley as a mentor, because he seemed very much like a young guy, very new to this sort of experience.
Yeah, yes, he did. But he seems very, he was excited about
it. Oh,
absolutely. You know, you can tell.
He was very excited. Who's next? I think it was all the New Japan guys, right? Oh, yeah, I think so. Because we had Bobby Fish and Kyle O'Reilly. Again, super, super humble dudes. Very nice.
Yeah, and Bobby Fish, he's a funny guy.
I
would love to hang out with that guy, too.
And you had a thing that we talked about, how we both like the fish tank, that little talk show they do. And they didn't, you know, they didn't brag. They just like, we can do some more, you know, too, soon, too.
Yeah, which was cool, you know. They didn't say, make a big deal out of anything.
Yeah.
So.
Tommaso Ciampa.
He was, honestly, I didn't expect him to be as vocal, you know, as he was. I asked him about his knee. I asked him, are you going to be wrestling with without the brace from now on? Because he took it off against Lethal and handed it to him. And he says, Yeah, I don't think so. It kind of depends on the weather, you know, how it's feeling. He said it wasn't feeling that good that day or yesterday.
Yeah.
So as you'll see, or if you watch the live event, he was wearing the knee brace.
Yeah, not as a heavy one, though, I noticed.
Yeah, I think it was just
a little lighter brace.
Yeah.
And then last but not least was Maria. And she was very nice, very, very approachable. We asked her, like, you know, oh, yeah, it's a shame that, you know, Mike can't be, you know, Mike Bennett, her fiance, can't be doing these signings with her because, like, he never gets booked for them. And, you know, she laughed. It's like, you know, yeah, it's like, you know, he's kind of bummed about it, blah, blah, blah. Very, very nice woman, very approachable, very easy to talk to, very well-spoken, I'd say.
Yeah, more well-spoken than we expected.
Yeah, you know? I think more well-spoken than she will get ever credit for. Like, I think people will look at her and always just assume, oh, hot chick, blah, 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 you know?
Well, I mean, even if you do look back at her WWE stuff, she did have a trouble on the mic in the backstage area, so... But I think that she has improved so much, and she's a woman in wrestling that, yeah, she's got the looks, but she
doesn't rely on it.
No, and she fits perfectly with what they're doing with her in ROH.
Got to meet a few guys from IWC, Assault and Battery, Miguel, Justin, a couple of the guys. So that was cool to meet them. A couple of them were sitting right by us, so we talked to them a little bit. So the show began with a pre-show match. Darius Thompson versus Romantic Touch. We weren't even really paying attention to it at all.
No, and actually...
Go ahead.
During this match, Alex actually noticed that JR was sitting in one of the boxes.
This was basically a hockey arena, and we were sitting on one side of the ring, and then on the opposite side, in the other team's, like, bench area, JR was sitting there with a bunch of other, like, I guess, like, higher-ups or whatever.
Yeah. And Alex was like, there's JR. And I was like, where? And he's like, you want to go up and try and meet him? And we're like, yeah, why not? What the hell? So during the match, we got up and walked over there. And Alex, you approached him first.
Yeah. I just walked up to him. Like, I waited till he was, like, not talking to anyone. Walked up like, JR, I just want to come over here and shake your hand. It's an honor to meet you, sir. You know, I just walked away.
Yep.
He said, oh, thank you, you know, and, like, just said thank you, and that was it. I didn't ask for a picture. I didn't ask for an autograph. I didn't ask for anything. I just shook his hand, walked away.
Yep. I walked up, did the same. I said, I'd love to shake your hand and thank you for everything, and then just went back and sat down.
Yep. And,
Which was awesome.
We shook hands with JR. So... And, like, you know, yeah, it'd have been awesome to take a picture with him or something, but, like, we didn't want to bother him. He was obviously there just to have a good time. So, you know, just boom, nice to meet you. Done. Okay. You know. So, show began. Words cannot describe how packed this fucking place was.
No, I mean, people were standing everywhere.
Yeah. There was 3,000 plus people. There's one way into the center area where the matches were taking place.
Yeah, it was like a bottleneck through one of the penalty boxes or something.
Yeah, so really need to fix that for next
time. Yeah, that was terrible.
Luckily, getting out of the show was easier, but, like, if you had to go to the bathroom or something, you're fucked.
The referee.
Before the show began, we met the New Japan referee, and again, really, like, he was, like, almost shocked that people would want to take pictures with him.
Yeah, he was sitting off by himself over by the merch table, basically, and we walked up, and we asked, like, oh, man, can we get a picture, and he was almost laughed at us, like, oh, okay, yeah, well, I whatever, guess, yeah. You know, so that was cool. He's humble, and, you know, he's pretty legendary over there.
Yeah. So, first match was Michael Bennett versus ACH, very fun match. Maria taking a spear on the apron was sick.
Great spot.
Yeah. Kudos to Maria for taking that. I'm losing my voice, as you can tell. What was next?
Was it the decade?
Yeah. No. There's one before that.
Oh.
Ah, fuck. Maybe what was that match next? Oh, we'll talk about that match. Remember it. We had the decade, BJ Whitmer and Jimmy Jacobs versus Briscoes and Red Dragon.
Yep.
You want to talk about that one at all?
It was a fun match, sure.
Okay. I'm trying to remember the guy. Roger Strong versus Cedric Alexander. A little more slower pace than I would have wanted, but it got picked up big time at the end. Roddy beat the shit out of Cedric.
Yeah, he really laid into him this time. slaps, those open palm strikes to the face just looked brutal.
Yeah.
This was a fun match. It kicked into high gear.
Yeah. Speaking of kicking into high gear, oh, well, after the match, they put him through, like, they did, like, a suplex onto, like, four chairs, which, like,
looked nasty.
Craziness. Then we had the Young Bucks, Forever Hooligans and Time Splitters, in a match. This crowd was super, super hot for this match.
This match was awesome.
Yeah.
This stole the show.
Absolutely. This was an amazing match. Just so fucking awesome.
So many spots that just... You didn't see them coming, too. Yeah. Like, you knew you were going to get a lot of spots, but they were just throwing... You think they go? We're going to go one way, and they jump out of the ring the other way. It's just...
Yeah, it was crazy, man. Absolutely awesome. Then we had intermission... I came back with Artie Evans, which was awesome. He had the new streak going on, including the Mexican version of it. Super funny.
Oh,
and apparently his close friends call him Papa Bear, which got a Papa Bear chant going. That's awesome.
He was saying that he got to choose his opponent for
tonight.
Toronto.
Yep.
And so he hands a piece of paper to Bobby Cruz and says, announce it. Bobby looks at it and kind of questions it to Bobby Cruz.
Immediately, Artie Evans rolls him up. His Ramon, Artie's assistant, takes off his shirt. He's got a referee jacket. Counts it. 1, 2, 3. Oh, my God.
That was genius.
Hilarious.
Just one of those things that it didn't overstay its welcome. It was perfect.
Yeah.
A little bit of comedy.
Oh, that was super funny. Crowd really liked that.
That was after intermission.
That was how we came back from intermission. Then we had Hiroshi Tanahashi and Jushin Thunder Liger versus Nakamura and Gato, right? Or is it Gato? Which one team with?
I'm not sure.
I think it's Gato that teams with team with Nakamura.
Yeah.
This is a very fun match. Liger was super fucking
over. Oh yeah. The place was coming unglued for Liger.
And it's really cool to see just how over he is in the US. Because like I don't think I don't want to sound like he gets he gets treated like shit in Japan, but like I don't think he doesn't get treated the same in Japan as he does in the US.
No, I mean, but again, he's a guy that they see all the time.
He's been there, done that in Japan.
Yeah.
And in the US, like he comes back and like, well, holy shit, this guy's back, Gato was a super great heel.
Yeah, he was getting booed. He was the only Japanese guy
one that got heat in that whole show, I think.
Yeah, I think you're right.
Super funny though.
Nakamura, dude, getting to see him.
Yeah, man.
Wow.
Nobu Maye, unfortunately, that was a bummer, but awesome match.
We did get to see the high fly flow,
which is awesome. And Tanahashi and Liger's basking in the cheers after the match was really cool.
Yes, it was.
A please come back chant, obviously, and like I think I would hope that Liger would come back. I think he'd be the one that comes back for anyone else.
Yeah, and he's been here before a couple times, so.
Then we had the four-way for the TV title, Lethal, Ciampa, Silas, and Matt Taven. Matt Taven got, no heat, no cheers, no nothing, really.
No.
I just got, sat my hands for him.
That was rough.
Kind of feel bad for him. Silas got some pretty good heat, and he was having fun, the fans throwing the streamers, he would, whack him away and throw him back in the crowd. So.
Point at the people.
I like that about Silas.
Yeah, he's a great heel.
Ciampa, Lethal, I like his new entrance, and like that new heel persona he's got going, it's pretty cool.
Ciampa actually went over the barricade when he hit knees
Doing like the knees, like running into the barricade, and like he came like right by where we were, and like right over the barricade near us, and that was fucking crazy. And then Silas does a suplex with him on the guardrail into the floor, and holy shit, man, fucking crazy. This match was craziness, man.
Yeah, it was, and I was worried that the crowd was going to be burnt out by the time this match started, because we were hot most of the night.
We had just slid Liger,
and so I was like, well, this is going to be the come-down match, and no, it definitely wasn't.
This was a really fun match. And then we got the Rainmaker, Kazuchika Okada, and Jado versus AJ Styles and Karl Anderson. The Rainmaker, that music hit, that place blew the fuck up.
Yeah.
And he did have the money. It was a little bit, it was a smaller entrance, but it was still cool. He had the money rained down, and we're just like, we're going to get some of that afterwards.
Well,
you did.
Oh, well, I was just like, oh my gosh, we were over there. And you're just like,
I thought to myself, the first thing I'm going to do when the show's over is go over by that stage and see if there's some of that money.
Yeah.
And, but this match was fun.
Yeah. Well, AJ and Carl Anderson came out, and I was very, I was like, man, I wonder if AJ's going to get booed, you know, because he beat Okada for the bell. He took away that Elgin Okada match we're going to see. I wonder if he's going to get booed in Big Heat, you know. And no, this crowd fucking cheered the shit out of him, man.
Yeah. I mean, these guys were, all of them were way over, yeah. You know.
So yeah, that was really cool. Like, just like the seeing AJ with that bell was great. Very fun match. No Rainmaker, which I was so bummed about.
Yeah, that was a bummer, but.
But we got to see the Rainmaker pose, which is like, that's awesome. I got a big pop from the crowd. Yeah, AJ wins the match against Jado. And then, like, just stare down with him and Elgin at the match. And then here comes Okada, and she's like, oh my
god. What a moment. What a moment.
It's like, please let this happen. You know? That was crazy. And then, like, AJ just posing with the belt, and, like, you could tell he was super, like, just thrilled at, like, how happy this crowd was for him.
Yeah, and he deserved that moment, you know?
I agree.
To hold a world title, a real world title.
A prestigious world title.
And in front of some of his biggest fans.
Against, you know, it's like, it's 3,000 fans, and that may not be as big as some of the TNA crowds he's worked in front of, but these were 3,000 fans that were in love with this dude.
Yes.
Also, one thing, like, during the match, Carl Anderson just, like, looks in the crowd, just like, Bullet Club's the most over thing in the world. That was super
awesome.
No Bullet Club merch at the show. I was super bummed about that, man.
Yeah.
That's bullshit.
I mean, they only had the New Japan, like, company stuff. Yeah, they didn't have any individual.
That's, I was super
that was
bummed
a bummer.
About that, man. And then we got the main event, Kevin Steen, Adam Cole. Kevin Steen, huge fucking pop for him.
Yeah, he was way over. Well,
oh my
obviously.
God, man. It's like, you know, I think he got a bigger pop than anyone in the night.
Yeah, and you know, there were certain spots in this match that I thought was a little too much, but I don't think there was a lot of people that really thought Steen was going to win this match. So
yeah.
The false finishes did work.
Oh, yeah, like they went pretty crazy. This was a really, really fun match. A couple times I thought, oh my god, Steen's going to win the fucking belt. So they made me buy into it. So
unfortunately, there was a complete drunk idiot in front of us.
Yeah,
directly in front of us.
Now, I don't know. He claimed he wasn't drunk, but it's like
you could see his eyes were glossed over.
He was
over.
A fucking asshole.
Just an idiot.
And, you know, he was worse than the Toronto cunt from all those other ROH videos. And if you guys watch old ROH shows, you know who I'm talking about.
Right. And I mean, in her defense, she's not trying to get herself over.
Yeah.
This guy clearly
was.
Over.
So. And I wanted to fucking slug him in the face. I was so fucking over it by the time the show got over. So yeah, after the show, had a great time. Noah runs up to the stage and manages to get Rainmaker money while I'm waiting around for some friends that I was supposed to meet up with. So we got Rainmaker cash, which is so fucking awesome.
Yeah,
man.
I had to kind of reach into the backstage area to get it because there wasn't any just laying about. So
yeah. And so, during this time, we're standing there, and just like, you know, we know it's like, oh, hey, people are taking pictures on the stage. So, just like, well, we should do that.
Yeah.
So, we go, we take one, and it turns out shit because the one does not work on a fucking camera.
Yeah, it looks like hell.
Yeah, so we're just like, okay, we'll do another one. We'll just wait, you know, we'll wait our turn. And during this time, my friend from Bushido Blog, a guy named Baxter, finds us because he sees us on the stage
posing
like the Young Bucks. And he's like, oh my god, there they are. So we get to meet him.
He's a super cool guy.
Super cool guy, yeah. Very, very cool. Really bummed we couldn't hang out with him more.
No, he got some Rainmaker money.
Yep, we got him some Rainmaker money. Or no, he found it himself.
Yep.
He was on the floor. And then we're just like, oh, well, hey, listen, can you take a picture for us? We're going to do the picture one more time because the guy went fucked up. And, like, we're posing. And as we're posing, we hear some
from
guy.
From across the whole arena, we hear this guy shouting.
Yeah.
He goes, hey, get off the stage.
So we're the ones that got busted.
Yeah.
Taking pictures.
So everybody else had to get off the stage, couldn't take pictures.
No, you can
there.
Do it on the ramp, but like he didn't want you on the stage.
Yeah.
Like, oh shit. Like, he was like, fuck it.
Hey, we got our picture.
Like, get off the stage. Don't take a picture there. We already got our picture.
Yeah.
Just, like, oh my god, man.
That was amazing.
So, yeah, we chilled at the show for a little bit and then we just went home. So, fucking crazy, crazy show.
Yeah. It was, and we were talking about this earlier in the room. I think this was the
best show we've been to, but definitely, definitely the best wrestling experience I've ever been, ever had.
Just, this was almost as good as going to a WrestleMania.
Yeah, I mean, and the signing, it was so worth paying to meet all these guys.
Exactly, man. We got our money's worth, man, for sure. So, absolutely. Like, I think it's like, I was like kind of like myself, like, man, I spent a lot of money on this trip, and it's like, you know, I wonder if it's worth it. And then, like, as soon as I got done with the signing, everything, it was like, this was absolutely worth it. This is a memory worth spending money for.
Definitely. And I don't usually spend a lot of money on merch or autographs or anything like that, so I was kind of back and forth on it myself.
Yeah.
And definitely worth it. We got all the autographs, we got great pictures, we got to, but the best part was meeting all the guys.
Absolutely.
The memories.
Yep. So we are now well into our trip home, as so we will keep you guys updated, I guess, when we get close to the bridge and stuff. But yeah, what a trip.
Yeah, definitely.
Greatest and best song in the world. Tribute. A long time ago, me and my brother Kyle here, we was hitchhiking down a long and lonesome road. All of a sudden, there shined a shiny demon. He said,
play the best song in the world, or I'll eat your souls.
Oh, me and Kyle, we looked at each other, and we said, okay. And we played the first thing that came to our heads, just so happened to be the best song in the world. It was the best song in the world. Look into my eyes and it's easy to see. 1 and 1 make 2, 2 and 1 make 3. It was destiny. Once every 100,000 years or so, when the sun does shine and the moon does glow and the dust does grow. Needless to say, the beast was stunned. A quick crack went from its tail. The beast was done. He asked us, be you angels? And we said, nay, we are but men. Rock. And the peculiar thing is this, my friends, the song we sang on that fateful night, it didn't actually sound anything like this song. It's just a tribute. You gotta believe it, and I wish you would.
All right, we are officially back in America now. We're quite a ways away from the border, actually.
Just stopped and got a bite to eat.
Yep, got some good old American fast food.
That's right. I'm feeling horribly uncomfortable, just like you should when you eat that stuff, so.
I'm all right.
Yeah, it's good. If you didn't eat enough. But, yeah, we got across the border, and that was
pretty easy, yeah. Significantly easier than getting... Or significantly less stressful than getting into Canada.
I would agree with that.
Guys were very nice. We did get stopped for like a car check or whatever. Because I guess it was just like part of like, you know, routine thing, you know, big deal.
They x-rayed the
cars. Yeah, the x-ray with like a pickup truck thing. It was pretty cool.
Yeah, it was neat.
Spoke to a guy from Canada who lives like right across the border, who like drives back in and out of Canada like all the time.
Yeah, that was cool to talk to him. I guess I didn't realize it was so easy for people to just move it.
I'm sure they have a way to do it, but like, you're so stuck to pay that toll every day.
Yeah, and I don't know if you noticed, but he did say A.
I did not notice that.
So
I'm disappointed I did not notice that. Yes. So we are now on the home stretch back to our places of home, I guess.
Places of home.
Place that we call rest. I still have a big headache. My throat is still killing me.
And it's Mother's Day, so we gotta go see our mothers.
Thanks, Mom.
Thank you, Mom.
Yeah. And so, we'll stop. We'll talk to you guys if anything else happens.
Hey, guys. As you can see, we are finally back. Well, Noah's home. I still got a little bit of a drive ahead of me, like 10 minutes or 20 minutes, whatever. So, yeah, this was the first ever road trip video or anything.
Yeah, this is our first road trip video, so.
I'm trying to think what we're going to call this little video series.
I don't know.
We still have some time to think about it. So, the name is below you. There you go. We did collect quite a bit of photos, so we're going to have a little montage of all the photos, so enjoy that. Don't know what we're going to do another one of these. Maybe for Chikara when we go to that show next month or whatever, but we enjoyed doing this, and hopefully you guys enjoyed watching it.
Yeah, and we'll have a review of the show out at some point.
Yeah,
watch for that stuff. But
right now we're just gonna try to sleep and relax.
Yep. So hopefully you guys enjoyed it. We had a blast.
Absolutely.
That was a trip of a lifetime.
Mm-hmm. That was only one way to end this thing out. Throw it up. Take care.